could go. If we could break through the ceiling above us, there'd be no point of us looking below. We could be free.
Plan is simple. We run in, Marco and I, we hit the water running, become Jesus for a moment, and actually run across that water. It looks like there's a queen and a big fish daddy. So we'll probably want to... The queen's probably going to be a spellcaster or something.
Sociology is useful in any organization. And
not really.
Now you know what's useful in any field.
Drugs.
Oh,
let's
see.
Computer.
I suppose
computers.
Oh, fuck, I forgot. Nice. I knew that was
good.
I have one.
I have some.
Okay, so.
I don't have mine.
Give me the cradle.
I stopped bringing mine because I just keep rolling on roll 20 because it's faster. Because I can just hit up and it'll go back to the last thing I was rolling.
How do I roll on this again?
You just type into it in the chat. It's like slash R and then space.
Oh,
and
I
you type
see.
In whatever you need.
Here, cool. Kratos dice, and I have. You can get a couple set of plastics. Since I have both my metal sets here. Okay. Doing some homework there, Marco?
Well, Tanner, I already killed the undead dragon.
I told him how to
Which
use
one?
It.
Well, just the one on the
Drake
Valley Drakes.
I just shoot arrows at it.
Well, no,
his arrows bounced
lightning
off.
Bolt.
Oh, well, I mean, that works too.
Yeah,
and then he had like 3 health left.
I mean, whatever gets the job done.
He had like 3 health left, so I just told him to throw a Molotov cocktail because he forgets he has that stuff.
I never use consumables. What if I need them later?
That thing would have wanted him if he went inside the slush mouth, slush fest.
Yeah, wouldn't have killed me. It's the strike where it hits you with its claw. That's what kills
mm-hmm.
you.
What?
Like this
right.
undead dragon in Dark Souls.
Oh.
Let's do that.
3D.
So the plan is we're gonna try to sneak in, but as soon as someone's detected, just blitz.
I'm gonna
get out of the tunnel. Slash R.
3D. Okay. That's pretty.
Then if you like, click on the chat box again, like you're gonna type, and just hit the up arrow key. To go back to whatever you were just on. Please don't crash the game, Marco.
I wonder how big of a number.
700 D12.
Hold on, now I'm curious. Give
Please
me a second.
Don't try
give
this.
Me, give me a second. Because now I'm really curious. Let me think.
Now hold on a second. 4,487.
What's a billion? 9 zeros?
Billion?
Can be.
Yes, it is. Million 6.
Okay, guys. If this crashes, I'm sorry. But I...
We gotta know.
I gotta know.
You rolled less.
Yeah, you messed up.
How did you get less on that?
You rolled a lot of ones.
So, what I was trying to see is how they save that number. Like, what kind of data type they use to save that number.
Mm.
So...
I mean, I suppose if we ever need to hide the chat log, that's the best way to do it.
Hold on.
Bury it.
Just give me a second. Because I bet I can do...
All right.
Mel's here.
Right. Now we can start.
Woo!
You sick again, Mel?
No.
Right. Just I noticed you're wearing pajamas. You don't normally wear pajamas.
It's 8 o'clock on a Sunday.
Those are appropriate pajamas for
today.
Yeah, also that. Thank you.
Okay, so do you know
I
what
was
we're
like,
facing?
These are the only
or did I fail to tell you
to? What?
Did I fail to tell you what we're facing?
Allowed by the Geneva Convention or what?
Yeah. You don't know what happens when I wear my normal pajamas.
No, I don't.
I have no idea.
We're facing the queen of the little octopus men.
Ooh.
And what looks like another fish daddy. But
nice.
How to get up there is there's one tunnel, and it's single file.
I'm never going to get tired of your inability to remember things from session to session.
Really?
It's like we've gone over the name of these things like 4 times.
Yeah. Well,
I
can
remember.
They start with the G, Glenn. They start with the G.
Grindy low.
There we go.
It's just...
All right.
Them little squid buggers.
Those Gladys things.
I can't remember their names, but I can remember how many of them there were, what weapons they had, and what position they were in.
I remember how to punch it.
I can remember how many there were, where they were, and what.
At the end of the day, isn't all you need to remember how to punch it?
I punched the fangs. Because it looked at me.
Alright, so what I'm thinking is we'll try to stealth as many of us in that cave as possible, but as soon as one of us gets detected, just run and get out of the tunnel, because I got a feeling that.
Why
queen...
are we fighting them?
Because that's where...
I was going to say, Glenn, do you want to recount?
Oh, that's right, you were gone last
session.
Recount what right. happened, because even Marco was here last time and
so
unclear.
We went through the tunnels, and we killed all the things in the tunnels, cleared all the traps.
Nice.
Still can't find Rosie and Sandara. We went in at low tide this time, and I found a secret tunnel that led to the Queen's Chamber with a big fish that has an auto grapple on its attacks.
There's Freddie Mercury.
There's also Sandara and Rosie hanging from a cage by the ceiling, and there's like chunks out of their legs and arms.
So congratulations, it mattered. We took a long rest.
That's
yes,
good.
So
and
get the benefits of a long rest.
So Mel, remember that big open room that we ended at the last time you were in there that had like all the skulls and things?
Oh yeah, the one where like Cole and I were traversing forward.
Mm-hmm.
It was a big circle.
We backed out from there, they took a rest, went the opposite direction, and moved all the way around the cave and got back to that spot.
Killing all the
and that's where the Queen's tunnel entrance is.
Yeah.
We weren't going to see it the first
time.
We were there during high tide.
Oh.
And so that it was concealed.
So, gotcha.
I mean, you could have found it. You guys just never went into the room.
There we are.
I was busy getting throttled by ghouls.
I mean, yeah, there's that.
And so the person
and
who has
got throttled by an octopus.
Oh, there we are.
The person who has advantage on seeing things in the water was currently unconscious.
That's true. True.
And the other one was gone.
Hmm. Now we're going to need you to roll well.
Yeah.
I was going to say, Mel, the only thing I did last time was shoot crossbow bolts, and I had Marco make some for you, so there's no net loss.
I also gave you 6 alchemist fire, so...
Oh.
Because I'm never going to use them, and you've proven that you are capable of throwing them.
Yeah. I've got a
it is worth pointing out
baseball.
The creatures submerged in water are resistant to fire.
Shoot.
I mean...
Well, if we survive...
As long as we take them out of the water...
But
we just boil the water away.
This fire does not go out with water.
We just boil the water.
It just rests on top of the water.
All right.
No, I mean, if you set someone on fire, they're still going to be on fire until they put it off. They'll just take half damage from it.
Got it.
I think.
All right.
So what? Maybe address what our plan is here, fearless leader.
All right.
Because we've already lost one member on this expedition,
right? Because when we last
left
off.
I live. I can hold
I
my...
I was abandoning you.
All right, so right now, I don't have any level 1 spell slots. Because
twos?
Some people are greedy with the heals. Hashtag Aaron.
I would have been fine without it. Because my mocks, I have...
So wait, have I
temp
gotten the benefits of a long rest, or do I...
Yes,
have
you would have had the benefits.
You've got everything back?
However,
okay.
I have...
And I think I put it all back in.
It's like, well, I was fine because I still had 9
okay.
temp HP.
I just want to make sure.
But, so the plan is, Marco and I are probably going to try to get in there first, because it is a single file tunnel. We're trying to get in there and get in the open area so we can, you know, not clog the tunnel up and have you all die from a area of effect spell that is funneled into a small tunnel.
Mel cannot shoot over my cavern.
The
creatures get
the
then you two can...
From your foes get... Her arrows get stuck in it.
You guys can figure out a fight amongst yourselves who goes first, but... We would. I believe there's a small ledge in the room, so you're gonna want to go in and off to the side, just so you're not in that tunnel.
Right. So, Marco, you get in there. You charge straight
up
the left flank, and then I'll get in. I'll go right up the right, and then you two, you come right up the middle, and we'll just go.
And so basically, just get out of the tunnel, start doing damage.
Keep our hit points above zero.
Exactly. Exactly.
The fish does a lot of damage. This is a long reach. And his to hit with grapples is so high that at our level it's pretty much gonna auto grapple.
Well, I can grapple it back.
But then I don't know what to do because I don't know what to do with
it. I have a +9 to grapple. Right.
Oh, let's
see
the show on the road, I guess.
Let's see.
So it's this way, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you actually have it open now.
What's that big red block?
Oh, that's a trap
that triggered. Oh, yeah, it was like one of those.
Lucky we didn't trigger during the fight, otherwise we would have died.
And so we all had to swim over and hold it up so Cole could swim out from under it. So he wouldn't get pinned.
Rip.
Let's say, is the map available to everyone?
You guys are all on it.
There it is. I just forgot it was mega
hidden.
So
that orange line under coal.
Yes.
Is the entrance to the tunnel.
Okay,
so it's like in the corner of the room is a little circular hole. That, I mean, you guys are like crawling through there. Like you, your size could like stand like hunched over. These guys are crawling.
It's about like theater crawl space.
Kind of.
Yeah.
Catwalk.
Kind of, yeah,
size.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Pretty chock full of seaweed, but like when you're in there, you're pretty sure like your head will be above water. If this was high tide, it would be totally full of water, but it goes down at like a 45 degree angle, like 7 or 8 feet, and then seems to even out. And you have not gone in any further than that. But
okay.
These guys tell you that it goes forward about 10 feet and then slopes back up into this cavern.
Okay.
So you guys can get in there, no problem. It's just single file.
Yeah, it's just a channel.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And according to Glenn, there's room in there to breathe.
Okay.
Like, water's not
you'll breathe,
all the way up there.
But it'll smell bad. It'll smell like Grindy, though.
So if anyone has a fear of suffocation, you should probably not be in the middle.
Man, make a character with a bunch of phobias that make combat impossible. In exploring.
Hypochondriatic cleric.
Hemophobia.
Alright.
I heal your wounds, but only if you clean the blood away first. I'm not.
Yeah, that's a feat.
Oh, I can't even look at it.
That's a feat.
Oh, that's right. It is one. You're in the lead, Glenn, so.
Alright, everyone ready?
I guess.
No, but.
Yeah, I agree with Marco.
Okay, I'm gonna roll a stealth check before I
agree.
I've never talked to these people before. That were sitting.
I think you talked to Rosie once.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I think.
I think that's right.
Who's the instrument player? Rosie?
It would have been a long time ago.
Yeah. Cass, Rosie said that any
so.
Friend with the halfling is a friend of mine.
All right.
I was going to say, I think Cole made friends with him on his first day.
Yep.
Cole made friends with everyone on his
Cole
first day.
Cole made friends with a lot of people.
Okay, so my stealth check is 15.
Can't
help it. I didn't
like the is anyone else sneaking in?
I
would like to
sneaking
attempt.
In.
Yeah.
Oh, making the attempt.
Do it, Marco. Do it.
All right, guys.
It doesn't hurt to try.
Watch this fail. Woo! 6.
Nice.
Okay, I was hopeful, but you know, not surprised.
Okay, cool. Do you have any cantrips that are going to be useful?
All
right, perfect. That's what I like to hear.
Try to move quietly when the fur is soaking up all this water.
Fucking, all right. Well, that was a crit.
Alrighty. So those Kratos dice are evil. You might want to set up the
I like them, though. But they don't roll
well.
Well,
you're rounding up the back end of this group, as Fearless Leader here says, alright guys, we're gonna get in there. Just moving quietly. Splash, splash, splash!
I'm pretty quiet. I mean,
you are. Right behind you is a giant, soaked sheepdog. And then Cole is, like, keeping his head right above water.
Can't go if the afro get wet.
I'm like,
all right, so
it took years to achieve this kind of.
I'm gonna keep sneaking forward. Just tell me
keeping
when to stop.
As close to the ceiling as possible, and like lifting up the bottom edges of the afro to keep it above water.
All right, just tell me when to stop, Tanner.
The vertical.
That's as far as you've gotten so far. So, are you? I mean, you're at the point now where it's gonna start sloping
just
up again.
Go up.
Do you want to get up?
Just
yeah, I want to go up.
Okay. Right now, your head, like, just the top of your head is, like, peeking over the very edge.
Okay. I'm going to take a perception.
Okay.
I'm going to look for things in the water, too, just to make sure there's no more Grindylows. They're sneaky little bastards.
Nice.
Got
an
advantage.
No, come back. I'll take another set, though, if you want.
Yeah, one sec.
I was going to ask, Cole, did you want to, like, heal yourself at all, or?
Oh, no, I have 2 spell slots left. Level 2.
Maybe you can use one of them.
I don't know. My plan is not to
15.
Get in harm's
way. I'm saying you're
way.
Down to my 15 health. I just...
My plan 15. Is not to get in harm's
Cole's
way.
Plan. Alright, so, Glenn, you're coming back in here, you're getting another look at it. What you're seeing is... It's not that big of a room, but the water in here seems to be swirling, kind of like the entrance was.
Okay.
With just, like, this is murky water. Like, it does not get cleaned out very often. Like, it's hard to see more than, like, 5 feet down into the water. Mm-hmm. And you're seeing just scraps of just bones and flesh and, like, dead fish just swirling around in this place.
Gross.
Rosie and Sandara are up near the ceiling in, like, this shittily constructed cage that has, like, metal bits on it, but also seems to be made out of, like, seaweed and, like, driftwood. Like, it's just bolted together. They have big, what look like silver ingots tied around their legs. They're not looking in fantastic shape.
Do I see any enemies?
You see one Grindylow that looks a little bit bigger than the others you've been seeing that seems to be singing at the moment. And some bulk is in front of her. Like, it's hard to make out what this thing even is because it's mostly underwater, but like some mass has like part of itself up on her lap or something. And that's all you can see right now.
All right, I'm gonna keep stealthing my way into the water. Graceful as a crocodile.
So as you move forward, singing stops. And that one Grindylow that you can actually see kind of perks up, is looking directly at you, and just hisses and screams in some language you don't understand. And then kind of like starts making signs.
Oh.
Ninjutsu! Get
and
down!
Quickly yanking out a dagger, she slashes at where it looks like there's like almost braided seaweed near the wall itself. And that cage starts to fall.
Can I make a dex check to get out of the way?
We can make an initiative, which is a kind of dex.
Andrew?
You're not wrong.
How's it looking in there?
Yeah, not good.
Oh, wait, I got a roll.
But she had higher passive perception than your stealth check.
I mean, at this point, it's a given that everything's going to be better than us. I'm at least out of the tunnel, right?
Yeah, you're out of the tunnel.
All right, that's all I needed to accomplish with my turn.
Silver ingots, though, eh?
They're probably lead. With our luck, it's probably lead. Hard to swim with lead. Hard to swim with lead on your feet.
Here. Here.
Picks a character that takes that literally takes you out of half of the elements. You can fight
literally.
Yeah.
Lee asked me the night before the campaign, like, can I have lead-toed boots? Alright. And I told him, I'm like, yeah, but if you have to, like, go in water, you're going to the bottom.
Glenn, what is your dexterity? Like, modifier? Or score?
One. I have enough dex to give me a plus one.
He's at the bottom of that fog.
Probably. Struggling to breathe.
What campaign is it?
Mine.
Oh, okay.
When you can just barely see is that bulk that seemed to be in front of her. Kind of like slips off, and you're seeing ripples in the water moving in your direction.
Alright.
But it's hard to see any more than that. But can do a cool thing. Give me 1 second.
Whenever the enemies do cool things, it's never good for us.
Oh, this is more of like a map. Cool.
Oh.
So if you scroll to the right, our depthometer has changed.
Yeah, it has. Well.
But you guys will not see this yet because you're not in there.
Yeah, I was like, what do you mean?
Yeah, that's not good. That's actually helpful though.
Yeah, it's a vertical slice of what's going on.
Can we use that map to move around, or still use the other one?
I'm going to keep track of both. This is more for like depth and water and things.
Alright.
Hey, Dino.
I'm gonna like.
I was gonna say your path is kind of blocked at the moment,
yeah,
but.
I'm gonna like delay my turn for a while.
You, I would say that you three that are in the tunnel could definitely hear, like you saw Glenn like move up, and he was like gonna try and sneak in there, and then you heard the singing stop, and something begins screaming. So you're aware that there's something going on.
Hmm. All right, guys, everyone just leave.
Right. Do you want to delay your turn until
right
after
Marco?
there was a screaming. That means
yeah, I'll delay until after Marco. So
or until after Cole.
Yeah, that's a better idea. I'll let them go first.
Okay.
He wants to delay until after me and then delay again.
Hammer! You've heard the sounds of combat.
You go forward.
And also possibly the muttered sound of oh shit under Glenn's breath.
Definitely the muttered sound of oh shit.
So
not gonna use a whole lot though. With only 3d6.
There's a 30-foot deer.
But it does have a 30-foot range.
Okay, what you can see is what you can see.
I've already used 40-foot.
There's one Grindylo far in the back that looks different than the others you've seen.
Mm-hmm.
And right about when you scramble to the top, you're seeing a big cage with Rosie and Sandara in it, slamming into the water over in that corner, right about where she is, and it's beginning to quickly sink beneath the surface.
Well, fuck. Well, it was nice knowing them. At least I have the hat, though.
So it's about, I'll say it was about 10 feet of movement to get where you
put
currently are.
Were you there for that?
I don't think so. Was I?
Here for what?
When I put the hat on.
I don't think so, no.
I don't think so.
But yeah, I have the hat now. So, you know what?
You can't put it on, it'll ruin your hair.
No, it just sits on top of it.
Is this like a ledge?
Got it.
Yeah. That is the point at which it stops being land and starts hitting water.
You said there was a depthometer here that I'm not seeing.
Now that you are up here, I can move you onto the depthometer. Fortunately, it's only too wide, so you're kind of in front. I guess that was murky as shit in here, so it's kind of hard to see very far.
Oh, that cage went a lot lower.
Yeah, it was up here. I mean, Rosie and Sinner seem to be alive, they just have silver ingots tied around their legs and big bite marks out of them.
Yeah.
And their hands are bound as well with like seaweed wraps.
Start now with the seaweed. Okay, let's see here.
So I'm gonna make it over here to that. They're in this cage.
Mm-hmm.
Are they conscious or unconscious?
They seem to be unconscious.
Is there, like, any kind of door on this cage? Like, what am I looking for here? What am I dealing with?
I would say that at first glance, this seems like a really shittily made cage. Just bolted together out of, like, driftwood, metal bars, and just wrapped together with, like, seaweed. If you want to have any more of an idea, you probably have to make a perception check. But this thing is like, it's tough to make this clear on initiative, but like by the time you sprint over there, it's already going to have like its top is going beneath the waves.
You said that it's like kind of like wrapped, almost like held together with the seaweed.
Kind of all over.
I want to try slashing some of that apart with my claws.
Okay.
You want me to like make an attack roll for that?
Yeah, I'll say that because of the way it's sinking, the only thing you'd really be able to attack is like the very top of it. Or if you want, you can try and make like an athletic check to like grab onto it and keep it from sinking. Either one.
I'll do that.
You want to do that?
I'll try to keep it for a second.
Okay. I'm going to say that, like, this is a big, heavy cage with two people in it, so.
Well, that's a 25.
All right.
Much
your arms are straining, and, like, you're sinking further in the water, but this the rate at which this thing is sinking is slowed down.
Okay.
Like, you're not fully able to counteract it.
Yeah.
But it's not sinking as quickly. But for the purposes of movement, you're pretty much grappled at the moment. It's going to be all you can do every turn to, like, keep moving vertically against this thing.
Spell and I would like to use our homeward bones.
Hey, let those back in the ship. Sorry, bud.
It's a good thing I have my,
what
my
would you like
home
to do now?
Miracle.
What do you want to do now? About 15 feet to get to there.
Okay.
Again, what you can see is what you can see. Split me.
Have you ever seen 15 or 20? What I can see is what I can see.
Basically, suck out the log. We just need one of those, except acid or water.
Alright, so.
So basically, we need.
This cage is submerging, correct?
A big towel.
It's starting to sink.
Always okay. Gotta know where your towel is.
Like, by the time you get up there, Marco was over there and you could just barely see the top of this cage.
I'm sorry, Douglas Adams.
And then this. And the water's murky.
Water is murky and just filled with filth.
Okay, so I won't be able to see it.
Like, it does not feel great as you're swimming in here, Marco, because you're like.
Yeah.
You've got like chunks of flesh and like half eaten fish like rubbing up against you. You cannot see further than like 10 feet down into this water.
Could I see Sandara and Rosie in there? Or
not by the time you get up there probably
okay.
Right now. All you see is a big cage. But
okay.
He would have described it to you before that they were in that cage.
Okay.
Now that you're up here, I can put you on the deckometer. So you'll be behind Glenn. Okay. Over to the right.
Okay. I am going to cast.
Yes.
hold on a second.
No matter
I
what
else. Expect you to die.
Yeah, I got that
one. Yeah, I'll cast Dissonant Whispers in the second level. Spell on that creature.
Okay. The one in the back?
Yeah.
Okay.
No. I got a sea bear!
Thing over there.